Raider Nation, what's going on? You're watching the Raiders Report Hard Knocks, Episode 3, What We Learned. It was a good show. I don't know if it was as good as Episode 2. Also, stay tuned. I'm going to give out some grades for on these shows. So, the way that this is going to go down, this is the five things that I learned on Episode 3 of Hard Knocks. The first one, the Madden ratings of the players was a little bit too low. Now, this was a fun thing that came out. Johnathan Abram was asked by the creators of Madden and the ratings, what did you guys think of the ratings? So, the only player who was like, yeah, I'm okay with it was Darren Waller. But Johnathan Abram was like, Antonio Brown should be a 100. He was a 98. He also then goes on to say that he should have been much higher. Derek Carr should have been a 90. He said that Karl Joseph was way too low. So, the number one thing that I learned here on the Episode 3 is that the Madden ratings were a little bit too, you know, a little bit too low. Now, there was a lot of other things that happened on today's show, but the Madden ratings was something that I thought stuck out because we did a Madden show. We had some fun with it. So, the way that we're going to do this part now is I want to ask you guys this question here. Is the AB drama over? Type Y for yes or type N for no. What do you guys think about the Antonio Brown drama? So, Johnathan Abram said that he should be a 100. There's only 99s, right? So, is the AB drama over? Type Y for yes, type N for no. Now, here's the next guy. Next thing that I learned. Waller. Darren Waller is underrated. The people at Madden, they asked several players, and Keon Hatcher finally came out and said that the guy that is the most underrated is Darren Waller. Which I think is interesting, right? So here's Darren Waller's career stats. 18 catches, 178 yards, 2 touchdowns. Obviously, he has not done a lot in his career. But Darren Waller, we know, is a very, very talented player. And when you look at his 2015 NFL Combine stats, the reason why he's been unguardable at practice is because of numbers like this. 4.46 40-yard dash. That is better than Devontae Adams. That vertical jump, 37 inches, better than DeAndre Hopkins. That broad jump, 125, better than OBJ. That 60-yard shuttle is better than Antonio Brown. Darren Waller is a very, very talented player, and it's why he's been called Gruden's best-kept secret. And number two thing that I learned, he is the most underrated Raider. That is according to his teammates. Also important to note, Hatcher and Johnathan Abram. We know Johnathan Abram. He's got that personality. Said that no defensive backs want to cover Waller. So I want to see more Waller in week 3 against the Packers. The number three thing that I learned. Hunter Renfrow's body is not very impressive. Like, Hunter is a great athlete who's going to be a great slot receiver. But he kind of got roasted on tonight's episode. So it was funny. Jon Gruden said, you know, we got to be bigger. We got to be better. We got to be faster. And then they show a picture of Hunter Renfrow without a shirt on. Hunter, all I'm saying is, like, I think I got better abs than you. Now, I'm not saying that that means I'm a better athlete, because I am clearly not a better athlete than Hunter Renfrow. But Hunter's body is something that I learned is not looking all that good. Derek Carr's joking around with him, you know, saying, dude, how old are you? Like, he looks like a little kid, and he kind of gets busted on for kind of looking young, but I can also tell if the Raiders coaches, the players, they're having a lot of fun with him, because the one great thing about Hunter, you can tell that he can take it. He kind of is just like, all right, man, I don't really care. I'm going to go out there and do my thing, which is something that I can really respect, which is also something when I think it's funny when people send me pictures of, like, NFL players, and they're like, look how good a shape he's in. Being an NFL-ready shape and actually looking good means absolutely nothing. Like me, I think I actually look okay. I am in horrible shape. I work out for looks, not to be in condition. Hunter Renfrow, though, I think I got you. So we got to get the Raiders report to 22K by August 22nd, okay? That's when the Raiders are going to play the Packers. I'm going to do another watch party. Currently, I'm at 21,059 subscribers. And if you're watching for the first time, shout out to y'all. YouTube.com/Raiders report. We got to get the Raiders report on YouTube to 22K by August 22nd. Raiders versus the Packers. So make sure you guys get in there. Click that big red button if you're watching on YouTube. Make sure you turn on those notifications so you know exactly when I go live. I see a bunch of people right now who are watching us live here on YouTube. So Alan, Joe, Quiet, David, Mile High Raider, Troy Butcher, Make sure you tell your friends to subscribe to the Raiders Report at youtube.com/Raiders Report. Now, for those of you that are new to the show, I got an awesome sponsor here, MyBookie, chatsports.com/Raiders, promo code GoRaiders. So if you love the Raiders and you want to bet on the Raiders this year, you got to go to MyBookie. But if that's not enough, you want a nice little cherry on top, if you will, anybody who goes and gets started at MyBookie, chatsports.com/Raiders, and uses my promo code GoRaiders, I can get you any Raiders jersey you want, okay? Go to chatsports.com/Raiders. You must use that link. And then you got to use my promo code GoRaiders. Send me a screenshot on IG or on Twitter at MitchellRen365, and I will get you any Raiders jersey that you want. Joe Ortiz says, let's do it. Joe Ortiz, you got it. Let's go to number four, what I learned. So essentially, knock on wood, when Jon Gruden gets done saying something that he wants all the players to acknowledge that they understood, he says, knock on wood. So basically, John's like, knock on wood. And the entire place does it. I like it. I think it's a lot better than clapping. I think it's something new. It's exciting. And the fact that as soon as he says it, it kind of gives me that vibe of, for all you guys that played sports out there or girls out there that played sports, when you walk and you hear your cleats like click-clacking, it kind of gives you chills a little bit. That's kind of what it sounded like. Everyone starts pounding on wood. It's fun. It's exciting. We tried to get a picture of knocking on wood, but awful, awful Google images started popping up on our screen. But overall, I like that it's a new idea. I think it's a fun idea. And you can tell that every single Raiders player is kind of buying into it a little bit. So knock on wood. So how about this? Everyone who's watching us right now, can you knock on wood? Type wood in the comments section. If you did it, I will 100% give you guys a shout out if you did that. Also, if you're wondering what you're watching, this is What You Learned from Hard Knocks Episode 3. So I'm giving you my five things that I learned. I'm on number four right now. So before I get to my very, very last one, okay? Before I get to my very, very last one, I want to ask you guys this. What did you eat when you watch Hard Knocks, all right? So what do you eat when you watch Hard Knocks? Normally when I'm at home, I'm watching a show, I'm like getting all sorts of food. I normally make tacos. I've been on this absolute taco kick right now. Also seeing some people, David, AB Plus, Kamara, Ray Jones, Indica Mitchell, Crazy Raider, giving some shout outs here on YouTube. Let's see. Anthony Gutierrez, Richard, you get a shout out. B. Ramirez, James Butts, James Farrell, shout out to you guys watching on Facebook. Much love to y'all. So, what do you guys eat when you, Haven Cash says, laugh out loud, I had tacos tonight. Absolutely. Three shots. Interesting. Chips. I don't know if you're just chanting wood or what. Somebody said bud. All good. And then somebody says Tiger Woods. I hope you don't eat Tiger Woods. Grilled cheese, tacos, all good answers. What do you eat when you watch Hard Knocks? The last thing that I learned, and it's something that I've kind of already known, Josh Jacobs is camera shy. Episode 1, Josh Jacobs wasn't on the show. Episode 2, Josh Jacobs not on the show. Episode 3, Josh Jacobs still is not on the show. And overall, I'm not too surprised, okay? One of the biggest reasons why I wasn't surprised is because literally after episode 2, Josh Jacobs tweeted out, the reason why y'all don't see me is because I'm hiding from Hard Knocks. So he seems like he's a little bit camera shy, which I kind of find surprising considering that he's from Alabama. So the fact that he hasn't appeared on Hard Knocks should not be ultimately too big of a surprise to a lot of people. Josh Jacobs, I think, is one of those players when overall, like the fact that he is camera shy, I'm okay with it. As long as he can go out in the field and get shit done. This is what he did at Alabama. 120 carries, 640 yards, 11 touchdowns, 5.3 yards per carry. Now, against the Cardinals this past week, he had 4 carries. For 21 yards, 5.3 yards per carry. He looked pretty solid on the ground. And I think ultimately Josh Jacobs is going to be this running back that the Raiders can really, really rely on. So Hard Knocks, the five biggest things that I learned from this week's episode. One, Madden ratings are too low. Johnathan Abram wasn't happy with the ratings. Madden, you got to get them up. Darren Waller is the most underrated Raider. That is from his teammates. That's what they said. Hunter Renfrow's body, not impressive. Hopefully his field play is much, much better than the bod. Hunter, if you get mad at me, hit me up on IG or Twitter, and you can yell at me all you want. Knock on wood. Knock on wood is essentially the thing that Jon Gruden says that he makes sure that his players know or that he makes sure that his players understand him. Hopefully you guys understood that. Knock on wood. Jacobs is camera shy. He has not been on episode 1, 2, or 3. Speaking of episode 1, 2, and 3, I got a question for everyone. Which Hard Knocks episode has been the best? So, 1, 2, or 3. So while you guys comment those, I'm going to give some shout-outs to some people on YouTube and on Facebook. So, Peter, what's up, Peter? Appreciate you watching. James, appreciate you watching. So, which episode was the best? 1, 2, or 3? Annika Mitchell says 1. Ryan says 2. Emmanuel says 2. John Maletta says 3. Crazy Raider says 3. Saying Havana Cash says 2. Tommy Powell says 2. May Spitfire 3. Well, how about this? Which Hard Knocks has been the best? Here's my answer. It's episode 2 has been the best for me. I like to see the fights against the Rams. I like that we saw a little bit more from Abram, Cleveland Furrell. We saw a lot of Antonio Brown. Episode 1 for me got a B grade. Episode 2 got an A grade. Episode 3 got a B grade. Make sure you guys are watching this show because I'm going to be live again August 27th at 10 p.m. Eastern Time for Hard Knocks Episode 4. Also, if you guys want to ever hang out with me, I got an opportunity for you. The Black Hole Kickoff Party. The Black Hole is sending me out to Oakland for Raiders versus the Broncos, week 1 Monday Night Football, and I'm going to be throwing a party. So if you want an invite to my own personal party, thanks to the Black Hole, Sunday, September 8th at 4 p.m., slide in my DMs on Instagram or on Twitter. And what I want you to say is just DM me the word party. That way I know that you guys are doing it. So DM me the party, okay? If you want a party, DM me party. And then also, if you're like, hey, Mitch, I see that there's a hotel up there. If you want to stay at the Radisson where the party is being thrown, I can hook you up with a deal. I can save you $100 on your first night. Cool? So Black Hole Kickoff Party. Who wants event deals? Let me know in the comments section. DM me on Instagram and on Twitter, party. And remember, I'm going to be live again, okay, for Hard Knocks Episode 4. So make sure you guys are watching that at 10 p.m. Eastern Time. Raider Nation, what's going on? Is this the number one Raiders channel on YouTube? For Chucky Heads, believe it, baby. And if you haven't already, subscribe right here. I'm giving you Chucky Heads news, rumors, Raider Nation rumors. And look at this. I'm making your life easier. Check out my next video. Thanks for watching, and go Raiders.